Hi there, how are you doing? Welcome back to English Simplified channel. As we have already learned the first and second types of experimental, they are pre-experimental and quasi-experimental. In this session we are going to cover and discuss a third type of experimental research design, that is true experimental. In order to have a better understanding, our discussion is divided into part A. What is true experimental research design? B. When true experimental research design is used. C. How is it applied and how its data is analyzed. Are you ready to rock? Let's get started. Part A. What is true experimental research design? Well, an experimental design is a way to carefully plan experiments in advance so that your results are both objective and valid. Furthermore, true experimental research is often considered the most accurate research compared to the other types of experimental research design. A researcher has complete control over the process, which helps reduce any error in the result. This also increases the confidence level of the research outcome. So, compared to pre-experimental and quasi-experimental, true experimental is the best, as it is more objective and valid. Alright, let's continue to part B, when true experimental research design is used. As you know, experiments are used to study causal relationships. You manipulate one or more independent variables and measure their effect on one or more dependent variables. Therefore, true experimental design is a statistical approach to establishing a cause and effect relationship between different variables. This is one of the most accurate forms of research designs, which provides substantial backing to support the existence of relationships. What does this mean? It's okay, we'll understand this better after discussing part C, that is, how is true experimental applied and how its data is analyzed. To answer this, there are five steps that we need to follow. They are: Step 1. Define your variables. Step 2. Write your hypothesis. Step 3. Decide your population and sample. Step 4. Conduct the experiment and analyze the data. And Step 5. Make conclusion and report the research. Let's see one by one. Step 1. Define your variables. What are variables? Well, a research variable, or also called a study variable, is an informal term that means any variable used in research that has some kind of cause and effect relationship. In addition, a research or study variable can be one of a wide variety of variables used in a study, including independent variables, dependent variables, and extraneous variable. Then perhaps question arises in your mind with the underlined words: What are independent variables, dependent variables, and extraneous variable? An independent variable is the variable that is changed or controlled in a scientific experiment to test the effects on the dependent variable. And a dependent variable is the variable being tested and measured in a scientific experiment. While in an experiment, an extraneous variable is any variable that you are not investigating but can potentially affect the outcomes of your research study. See this example. Suppose that you are doing an experiment in which you want to prove whether a product of a fertilizer is good to increase the fruit of orange, then you test it. In this case, the fertilizer is termed as the independent variable because it is the source of the effect to the orange plant, while the number of the oranges is termed as the sample. After a while, or having given the fertilizer, then you the result. Well, say that it's true in which the orange plants now are having a lot fruits, but questions arise: is truly only because of the fertilizer, or perhaps it is because the time you do the experiment, the weather is suitable for the orange to produce fruits, and also because of the soil or other factors that may influence, so that the orange has or increases its fruits. So that is the meaning of independent variable, dependent variable, and extraneous variable. As in this step we focus on how you define the variables. Then, in defining it, you should begin with a specific research question or research problem. What is research question or research problem? A research problem or question is a specific issue, difficulty, contradiction, or gap in knowledge that you will aim to address in your research. A research question is a question that a research project sets out to answer. For example, I want to find out if a teaching strategy, namely story map, will affect on my students' reading comprehension. So I formulate the research problem or question as follows. Does story map affect on students' reading comprehension? Based on this research question or problem, then I define the research variables. They are, the independent variable is the story map, because this will bring the effect, while the dependent variable is the student's reading comprehension, because this is the result that I want to prove, or find out whether story map affects it, or not. Alright, as you now have understood what variables are, and how to define it, now let's continue to step 2. That is, write your hypothesis. Before writing the hypothesis, it is good to understand what hypothesis is. Well, hypothesis is an idea or explanation for something that is based on known facts, but has not yet been proved. In addition, a research hypothesis, also called a scientific hypothesis, is a statement about the expected outcome of a scientific study. Normally, in experimental research, there are at least two expected outcomes or hypotheses. They are the null hypothesis or HO and the alternative hypothesis or HA, in which the null hypothesis is the claim that there is no effect in the population, while the alternative hypothesis is the other answer to your research question. It claims that there's an effect in the population. For example, back to the research question. Does story map affect on students' reading comprehension? As I want to prove whether story map affects or doesn't affect the student's reading comprehension, then I write the hypothesis as follows. The null hypothesis. There is no significant effect of story map on students' reading comprehension. While the alternative hypothesis. There is a significant effect of story map on students' reading comprehension. Okay, now let's proceed to the step 3. That is to decide population and sample. What is meant by population? A population is the entire group that you want to draw conclusions about or from which the sample is taken. Then, what is meant by sample? A sample is the specific group that you will collect data from. The size of the sample is always less than the total size of the population. So, how sample is selected from the population in a true experimental? As you have to know, in true experimental, the sample must be selected by random sampling and random assignment, in which randomization in an experiment is where you choose your experimental participants randomly. And in experimental research, random assignment is a way of placing participants from your sample into different treatment groups using randomization. Furthermore, with simple random assignment, every member of the sample has a known or equal chance of being placed in a control group or an experimental group. Let's see the example of these statements are applied. Once again, random sampling, also called probability sampling or random selection, is a way of selecting members of a population to be included in your study. So, here are the steps how you should take sample in a true experimental research. 1. Write each name in a folded paper. 2. Shake the box. And 3. Pick as many sample as needed. In experimental research, it has at least two groups of sample, which is called control and experimental group. Then we have to divide this sample into two groups by applying random assignment. You use random assignment to place participants or sample into the control or experimental group. And here are the procedures. As this is just an example of you understand what random assignment is, so, in this example we need 4 persons in control and 4 persons in experimental group. So, 1. Write 4 control group and 4 experimental group, then fold the paper. 2. Shake the box. 3. Ask the sample to pick 1 folded paper for each. 4. Who pick control and experimental group become a member of control or experimental group. So, that's an example of how to randomly and manually take the sample in true experimental research design. In fact, there are some ways of taking the sample randomly, such as systematic random sampling, cluster sampling, or by using the computer. If you want more information about this, that's okay to find my video tutorial dealing with probability sampling techniques. Alright, now let's move on to the 4th step, that is, conduct the experiment and analyze the data. So back to the example of the research question or problem, does story map affect on students' reading comprehension? So, simply, here are the procedures. I have two groups of sample, namely control group and experimental group. So, the first step is to test these two groups of sample with reading comprehension, what it's called pre-test. It means, you have to firstly test the sample in order to have data. Then the second is to give a treatment or teaching the experimental group by story map, while a control group is without story map, or let's say just receiving conventional method. After that, I again test the student's reading comprehension, and this is called post-test. Then finally, I analyze the data by t-test analysis. So, that's an example of how to conduct a research designed by true experimental. And now we have come up to the last step of true experimental research design. Step 5. Make conclusion and report the research. This how you make conclusion of a true experimental research. 1. If the p-value is lesser than or similar with 0.05, or 2. If the t-value is higher than critical value, then it means the null hypothesis is rejected, or in other words the alternative hypothesis is accepted. For example, in my research, does story map affect on students' reading comprehension? I analyze the data and find out that p-value is lesser than 0.05, and the t-value is higher than critical value. Then my conclusion is to reject the null hypothesis, that is, there is no significant effect of story map on students' reading comprehension. So, this is, for example, is crossed, and to accept the alternative hypothesis, that is, there is a significant effect of story map on students' reading comprehension. All right. That's it, our discussion for true experimental. Hopefully this has broadened your knowledge. Our next topic of discussion will experimental research design with its type called factorial design. By the way, don't forget to support me by your subscribe if you haven't. Thanks, and ta-ta.